Aaron Barnwell back there. We've got a huge six-man tag going on here, but I'm still stunned at what we saw in the last segment. My broadcast partner all night, a great friend of mine, Rod Steele, just seemingly turned his back on the whole line of defiance, knocking them all out with chairs. I don't know what to say here, fans. I'm just going to try to be a professional and call this match and speak of the devil. Walking back into the broadcast booth. Rod Steele, Rod, I'm going to try to get to the bottom of what happened there. But right now, I really don't want to talk about it, not in the state of mind I'm in. Let's talk about coming to the ring right now. It's Tommy and Johnny Vandal, David Babylon. They're going to be taking on those guys across the ring. 911 Incorporated, Steve Madison, the Shane Brothers, and of course the guy who has a big score to settle with Johnny Vandal, Ron Neely.
Ah, yes, Aaron. How you doing, by the way, my good man? Let's take a good look at the athletes involved in this. I won't bother with some details we just saw transpired. Look at the athletes involved. We've got guys like the Shane Twins. Oh, Broadway Joe.
That's not the Rat Magnet camera guy.
There's your Rat Magnet, David Babylon.
Oh. There we go.
50-year-old males that have to be gay.
Explains the date mishap there with 11 staples in the back of Rod Neely's head, thanks to Johnny Vandal's errant chair shot. I saw them myself. It was quite the gruesome sight. What do you think about that, Aaron Oil?
Yeah, I think there have been a lot of errant chair shots around here very recently, Rod Steele. But again, I need to try to call this match. Normally, I'd be going off in the tirades of Rod Neely, going out there single-handedly, trying to get us kicked off of television. Of course, that's Frankie Capone's gimmick as well. But obviously my mind a little cluttered, but I'm a professional. I always say it. I am where the bar is set here as far as announcing goes in the wrestling industry. And I'll make this match no different. There you have the Vandals and David Babylon. Good friends, but have not teamed all that much together. Whereas at the Shane Brothers, they've teamed together on several occasions. They've been a stablemate with Steve Madison for nearly a year now. These guys are a well-drilled unit. You've got to see the Babylon and the Vandals can hang with that kind of pressure.
You look at guys like the Shane Twins, guys who are huge, they're fast, they're unbelievably talented. You know, by the way, big takedown there by Mike Shane. Aaron, I'm sensing a little tension from you. I'm not sure where that's coming from.
No tension whatsoever, Rod Steele. You know, Rod, I don't mind playing peacemaker, but this is going to be a bit hard to smooth over, don't you think?
I don't know what you're talking about. More importantly, you see the size differential now between one Vandal, Ricky, Tommy.
How in the hell can you be teaming up with Mikey Tenderfoot?
What are you... Listen. Mikey Tenderfoot and I have been around the world, my friend. We've been around the world. The I Quit match is just the tip of the iceberg. Mike Sullivan, Scoot Andrews, they thought they had something going over on Mikey Tenderfoot and Rod Steele. Not just no, but hell no. You see, we fooled a lot of people now, didn't we?
You certainly did, Rod Steele. I'll give you that. I don't know what has gotten into your head. Maybe these mind games, the new cryptic Mikey Tenderfoot, with his old weird pal Justice, have gotten into your head. Maybe you're going to be hanging around that Antonio Banks character. Gee, I'm really starting to wonder who that mystery partner tomorrow night might be, Rod Steele.
I wonder indeed who it could be, and I guess if I... No, I don't. Hey, now we're on television here. What I want to talk about right now, though, is Steve Madison's pure power. He's been in Japan. He's faced guys like Kenzo Suzuki. He's faced guys like, well, I don't really can't pronounce their names correctly.
But now Steve would never, ever put me in this position. He's a true professional working his way up the ranks of IBW.
Absolutely. And speaking of professionals, let's look at these two athletes involved in the ring, okay? Now, we're going to cut to a... Whoa!
Hell, that's your gimmick.
Well, he just wants to make sure he doesn't waste the sweat on his hand.
Big slap to the face of our TV champion, Steve Madison, by Johnny Mandel. Swinging almost as wildly as his hair out there. Steve Madison misses with a big right, now misses with a big left. Johnny Mandel playing games with Steve Madison. I never thought I'd say that. And with the big atomic knee drop, and Steve Madison having to take a powdown.
You know, I gotta tell you, I don't know if it's a wise move on the part of Johnny Vandal to be shaking and baking, juking and jiving on the likes of Steve Madison. Like it or not, this guy is our IPW World TV Champion. And see, here he is, showboating, pandering. Oh, and there he goes right to the eyes of Steve Madison. And what Star Stevens doing in the middle of this ring here? He's not, what I don't get is, how come he's not calling this particular matchup? He's obviously hit him in the face. Oh.
A bit of tension on there in the baby's face corner. That's what you're talking about. The guys that haven't been together a lot and guys that hold a lot of the gold here at IPW. It's not just the AOD with all the gold, I gotta admit. Shane Brothers just taking the head off of David Babylon. They'll be defending those Florida Unified Tag Team titles tomorrow night in Ybor City at Born to Ride, 9 p.m. against the Lost Boys. And another guy coming in from Wildside besides them, Sour Nario, taking on Roderick Strong, a member of the AOD who will win, Rod Steele.
Look at Todd Shane now going for the TKO. David Babylon fighting valiantly back, but he can't hope to match the size, the strength. Look at the pecs, look at the delts, and look at the quads on Todd Shane. There is no way he can hope to match up strength with him. Going for the sunset flip, but Star Stevens finally there for the count. Breaks it up. Big goes to the close away. SDO, they call the ego trip, and down goes Todd Shane. David Babylon goes for the tag on Ricky Vandal, or Tommy Vandal. I never get those two straight. Not that I care. Now they're going to double put him into the corner, and they're going to whip the big man off. They're going to go right in now. What do we see here?
We don't see anything as of yet. Oh, Tommy Vandal, big wizard in the corner. Absolutely destroyed. Oh, he's going after the other Shane. I can never tell him apart. That's no secret, Rod Steele. And one of the Shanes comes just a clubbering on top of Tommy Vandal.
You can't think you're going to get away with not getting around on these two guys. Look at the size there. Both 300-plus pounds. Steve Madison's probably pushing 235. Miracle of modern science, indeed. I mean, medicine. I mean, what is he again? Modern-day miracle? Dropping elbows a la Buck somebody or other. I'm not going to mention his name like I care. But now here he goes. There he goes. Rosie's going to cover now. Star, get down there and count.
All these guys wound up for the big show tomorrow night. Norman Smiley will be taking on Tommy Vandal if he can somehow get to this match. Unfortunately, Steve Madison will be taken off to Japan to defend IPW's honor there. And Babylon and Johnny Vandal will be in a big five-man scramble for tickets, 727-526-6778 or www.ipw-hardcore.com. You've got to come see the insanity. Kevin Sullivan and Abdul the Butcher, Chaos and New Jack, Hardcore Battle Royal. The list goes on and on.
Shane Twins. You got guys like Rod Steele, Antonio Banks, Mikey Tenderfoot, Justice, Naftali,
Dustin.
What?
Four quarters of flag. Why am I having a back and forth with you, Rod Steele? I'm a little angry with you right now. It's always us children who have to suffer.
I'm sorry. I'll take you to the park, Admiral. I'll even see what's something in that hairless of yours.
And if you don't offer me ice cream right now, we're going to have a problem, Rod Steele.
Okay, but now let's get back to watching one of the Mike Shane Todd guys clubbering these guys left and right. That's Mike Shane tagging right back in. Yeah, what's David Babylon doing? All he's doing is hurting his boy, the Vandal number two. There he is, big snap suplex here. Look at these guys. I hate to say it. 911 is working like a well-oiled machine.
Yes, they are. I hate to say it as well. Everyone knows how I feel about Ron Neenan. I tell you what, we got a big six-man going on here, but a six-man of another sort right here on TV next week and it means a whole lot here at the front of WrestlePlex. Defending the honor of the WrestlePlex will be Hot Ass Andy Love, Mikey Batts, and Eric Stevens as they take on those current boys, David Mercury, Stash, and the Monster T-Bone.
Oh, yes, the Steve Kern School of Professional Wrestling. We got to care about them. We got to give big shouts out to them. Not really, no, but what I'm really going to talk about is guys like Navy SEAL teaching down at the Florida WrestlePlex. Backslide here. One, two, oh, and kick out. If you ever wanted to be a professional wrestler, call 727-526-6778. Another attempt there by Vandal. Oh, and he's taken right out of his boots by Mike Shane. He's killing him in there.
You might be able to swing a chair, but you just missed two near falls right there. Something Aaron Lyle would never do if he wasn't in shock. How could he be doing stuff with Mikey Tenderfoot after the match? He beat you, Rod Steele.
You know, he did beat me, and on that night, he was a better man than I am, but I learned something from wrestling Mikey Tenderfoot. Night after night after night, Miami, Davie, whether it's St. Petersburg, whether it's Tampa, Ybor, all over the world, I learned something. I learned that this kid is not going to quit. And I also learned something else about him. I also learned he's a very, very, well, I'm not real sure what else I learned, but here we go for a big backdrop there by Todd Shane. And all of a sudden now, the tide is easily leaning in the direction of 911 Incorporated.
I'll tell you what. Let's talk about the AOT again real quick. Rod Steele, you told everybody, stay away from that I Quit match. The AOT didn't help you, and you came out a loser. You're never going to have the AOT in your corner again. How do you think you're going to fare now, okay. Rod damn champ?
Oh, you know what?
Oh, look at that, Tommy Vandal, just about to get Steve Venom with the suplex. These guys know each other well. Big reversal. Oh, he drops Steve Madison right in his head. Does that Tommy Vandal?
Both men are down on their feet. You know, I tried to come out here, and I tried to be civil about it, but since you want to bring it up, when Rod Steele lost the World Heavyweight Champion, I didn't see a single member of the Alliance of Defiance. However, when I was in the cage,
oh,
and raising the cage.
Oh, here, that's right. On both individuals, Tommy Vandal trying to get to his corner. He needs to desperately, but Steve Madison, he's not faring very well himself. Whoever can make this tag will most certainly give their team a huge advantage.
Now, if you're looking, Vandal number two is actually in the wrong corner. He's going to try to make the diving attempt. Finally, he gets in. Johnny Vandal, he doesn't know what's going on here. Here comes Mike Shane. Big forearm, kick to the groin. Here he comes again, another big forearm, another shot to the groin. He's killing him in there. Steve Madison looking a little confused. All of a sudden, blocks the foot, hits the curry, out goes Steve Madison. All four members of the Alliance of Defiance, excuse me, the AOD. I don't know who I'm talking about. Please, everyone, help me.
Over the top of Johnny Vandal. Take it out, Steve Madison. David Babel out of there. Taking it to one of the Shane brothers. I like to call him the Burn Shane. Taking it right to the chest. New bit of offense there. What's he doing? Oh, no. It don't matter. It's the Shane brother. Has him up.
TKO, David Babel with that super kick there by Vandal number two. And here comes the Shane putting those big forearms to him. Whips him into the corner now. This kid's unbelievably moving around like a sack of potatoes. Oh, and another super kick by Vandal number two. All three members of 911 Incorporated are down. Oh, but there goes the mistake. Down goes David Babel. Up he goes. Oh, rock bottom. That's cool. One, two, three. What?
No, a two count. Johnny Vandal making a save. That absolutely would have been it, Rod Steele. But look, the Shane brothers back up again. And Johnny Vandal touches and they clothesline each other. I can't believe Johnny Vandal hanging in there with the Shane brothers.
Look at Johnny Vandal now high up on the top rope. Look at that. Oh, and Steve Madison grabs the leg. He's holding him tight. He could be sending over that top rope brain buster or the rocket drop, as he likes to call it. If he hits this, I swear to God, this thing is over. He's getting him up. Uh-oh.
You know who else does this very, very well? Mike Sullivan. Huge superplex off the top rope, and that's it, folks. One, two, three.
You can count to 100. Steve Madison with a big win for 911 Incorporated. Aaron Royal, it's been a pleasure tonight. You have no idea.
Yeah, whatever, Rod Steele. I'll be taking care of that situation. But right now, the winners of the match going on to bigger things tomorrow night in Ybor City, Steve Madison and the Shane Twins. And unfortunately, that means one more win in the cap of Ron Nene. Fans, Aaron Royal will be back, hopefully without Rod Steele, next week.